Hey guys, it's Miss Kate. We are back. We did work a little bit on the Google Meet, and what I found is that in order to join us live, which we will be doing every Saturday right around noon, you have to go to your Google Waffle. That's those nine little squares up in the right-hand corner of your screen. Click on the Google Waffle, click on Google Meet, or Google, Google Meet. Click on Join a Chat. And then type in Art Fun, ARTFUN, and you should find us right there. Otherwise, if you can't figure it out, send your teacher or me a message and we will send an invite through email. So this is our challenge number 5, and it is the one paper challenge. So you get to pick one paper that you can find around your house. We have regular computer paper. I found some notebook paper, just some colored art paper, and you can cut it, rip it, tear it. You can use tape if you want. You can use anything around the house, and you are going to build a sculpture with it. We are going to do a 4-minute sculpture with ours, so I'm going to set my timer, and you guys can watch us make our sculptures and join us and post a picture of your own sculpture that you come up with. So here's our timer. I'm going to set that for 4 minutes. You guys ready? Mm-hmm. All right. You have 4 minutes to make a paper sculpture.
You're going to do it too?
I am, yeah.
What are you doing? Fortune teller. All right. Is that what you're doing here?
Now, you guys don't have to be exact when you're doing this. This is just fun, creative, exercising of your brain. I miss you guys. I would much rather be at Pang Hollow, hugging, high-fiving, fist-bumping, at the door, seeing you all every day. Is like a cornucopia. This kind of reminds me of when we did the paper sculptures. Some of you guys last year made some amazing paper sculptures with all kinds of fun stuff coming out of the tops and the sides. And I remember TJ made a water slide coming out of his. I'm just using a pencil to kind of wrap my paper around, just to make it look interesting. All right, guys, you have 2 minutes left. 2 minutes and 16 seconds.
It's going by so fast.
That's why it's a challenge.
I'm not going to have enough time.
You're going to have just enough time. If this is the first video that you guys have watched, these are 2 out of my 3 kiddos. My daughter, Anna. And my son Cameron. And Levi is not in this video. This video takes a lot of motor skills, and Levi has cerebral palsy, and using his hands is very hard for him. So Miss Kate's gonna do his for him today. Oh, Will likes to make these things. I'm gonna make one of these. We're going to put that on the sculpture. 1 minute and 30 seconds, guys.
Yeah.
Now, at home, you guys don't have to time yourself. We are in a bit of a time crunch here. We set up a Google Meet, and Miss Carrie and Miss Kara and I kind of got to talking during our Google Meet, and we used up a lot of our afternoon doing that. So, what? 1 minute and 1 second.
I'm not gonna have enough time.
I need some tape, man. I'm gonna tape mine to the tape. 42 seconds. This guy needs like needs like an assistant.
My guy's falling apart.
Stand up, Mr. Buddy.
Keep going. You can always finish. This is not, a end all be all. Cameron's got what do you call these things? A fortune teller going. He can decorate that if he wants. I've just got a random sculpture. Another fun idea, I'm going to open my shades here. I don't know if you guys are aware, but it's a thing now to make some hearts and rainbows and put them in your windows just so that people who are out enjoying the day can feel a little bit of joy and hope in seeing your beautiful creation. So that's another awesome opportunity that you have. I'm not going to make it an art challenge right now, but it's just something you could do to make everybody around happy. We are going to finish up our sculptures. I hope that you guys follow along to this video and post your pictures in the comments. And if you need help with figuring out how to upload photos, I know that Kaysen just put a response on the Google Classroom, and that should be helpful.